because we make it too confusing, we put too much information. It's not about that I will, it's I can't. Now, throughout tonight, I'll give you my insight and my struggles so that you can trust me that I'm good enough for you, that you can go home tonight and believe what I have to say might help you in your journey as well. And that's how we come down to this question, why diets don't work. How many here tonight are on a diet? Hands up. Okay? No, hands up on those. Diet? Hands up those who have never been on a diet. Wow. Hands up those who are thinking about going on a diet on Monday. Okay. So which Monday? I like that. Who said that? I like that. Which Monday? All right, always Monday. So basically, we're talking about why diets don't work. A lot of people will say calories in, calories out. But it goes beyond that. I'm here tonight to put those whys together. Don't get me wrong, we all have the intention when we do want to go on a diet. The intention is there that you really want to say, this is it. I can do it. I'm going to go on a diet. And I love that. I see the passion in people's eyes when they want to go on a diet. But somewhere in between the intention and the success, the whys are broken. So I'm here to put those whys together somehow. I'm not an electrician, but I'll try. Okay? I might get electrocuted. There you go. So, some people don't know what they want. The founder of Apple. Who was the founder of Apple computers? Steve Jobs. Said, people don't know what they want until you put it in front of them. Until that happens, we don't know. That's where the diet companies get it right, because they know what to put in front of you. And we're too gullible to take it. And that's why they're still in business, and that's why their pockets are always full. And you aren't full because you're starving yourself, because diets don't work. And that's why, starvation. So we're all here tonight to find out, what does a weight loss king know about why diets don't work? What does he have that he can share? It's all about sharing. That can help anyone here tonight to move forward. And that's what it's all about. Sharing is caring, right? Okay. So diets are short term. There's no quick fix. There's no magic pill. Even though there's people out there that would promise you the world and give you broken promises. How often have we been lying in bed watching TV at 3 o'clock in the morning and there's an info commercial? Buy this ab roller, move side to side, get this six pack. My bed was full of them. Under my bed, sorry. They said, you buy this, you can fold as compact underneath. Great, I could put more stuff under my bed. Until Mum said, so I can't vacuum under your bed anymore. So they had it down pat. They knew at 3 a.m. or 2 a.m. in the morning, you are your most vulnerable. You're in bed, you're emotional, you just picked out an ice cream, watched a sad movie. So they know when to strike. They strike it when your emotions are down. And they get you. They give you false hope. I'm not here tonight to give you false hope. I'm here to give you the truth. I'm here to give you what I've done. Not only lost 75 kilos, which is just a number, but I've managed to keep it off. And that's what it comes down to. And I'll give you the solutions tonight of how to keep the weight off. So, I struggled all my life. give some information about myself. For 25 years I struggled. Being overweight from a young child, 8, 9 years old, Mediterranean background, love my background, love my heritage, and I love my food. That's why diets don't work. Because, let's face it, who doesn't love food? Who doesn't get enjoyment from food? And that's where we need to connect those wires together and fix up that relationship that we have between food. Because diets don't work, because what it does, it actually makes us a bad relationship with food. And we cannot do that. Yes, food is energy. That's also pleasure. Back at home, being from a maintaining background is also a way of giving, sharing, family together. So it serves more than just energy and pleasure. It's also a way of life and culture as well. Okay, so I was 8 years old when I was starting to get overweight. 25 years until I reached the age of 33. In between that time, it was a pretty sad life, I suppose. Being bullied, being overweight, leaving Sydney, going to the Hunter Valley, being around, at that time back in the 80s, I stood out because I was also ethnic and overweight. I was a target. I was a big target. Really big target. And that's fine. And that basically lowered my self-esteem, lowered everything about me. But kids are kids and that's how it is. So I've been through the struggles. I've been in the attic, in a dark, dark, dark room, the shades down. Don't want to go anywhere, don't want to do anything, because I was fat and I was ugly. That's reality. Sorry? And I ate some more, because you know why? Why did I eat some more for? Yeah, because food was my friend, exactly. It never answered me back, it was always there, it was warm, it was delicious. It was there, I wasn't rejected. Never had a girlfriend until I was probably 22, 23. That's where I came from. Until I reached 33 years of age, and that's how big I got to. This is my original suit that I had made. Anybody know the Burwood area? There's a guy that makes suits, Mojo. Yeah. Let's see, you open this up, you'll see. Let's have a look. Oh, got the belt on, sorry. But yeah, it's there as well. So a specially made suit. 33 years old, 150 kilos. Now throughout my whole journey, I tried diets, absolutely. I must have tried 20, 30 diets, from the low protein to the high protein to the low carbs. to the cabbage diet, the detox diet, every single diet. But that always failed.
So you were married at this time as well? What age did you get married?
I was married at 25.
And what about your wife? Like, did she go on those diets with you, or would she support you or disappoint you?
My ex-wife at that time always supported me. The support was, and as we all know, support is important as well. And some of us don't have that support. So we need to find that support. I have a solution for that as well coming up. So she was always supportive, always there. She would see me on the ups and the downs, and the ups and the downs. And we know what that's all about. One of the most famous people in this world, always yo-yo dieting. We know who she is. That's Oprah. Up and down, has everything at her disposal. Trainers, speakers, nutritionists, everything. Chefs. So what does this say to you? Diets don't work.
Right.
Diets don't work. so I really understand the struggles. But in it tonight, we know what's going to happen. What's going to be the take-home message tonight? And what's going to be your question? Exactly, but I will give you the solutions. I'll give you the solutions. So, and that's what it's all about. So throughout my whole life, yes, I attempted every single time. Once again, 2003, Easter. Ooh, something was different. I get to do this when I talk about this. My moment of truth. We'll come back to that. Now, it takes something to really happen to move you. Now, 3 in 5 Australians, 12 million Australians, right now are overweight. 75% of heart victims who have a heart attack will go in the second time they have a heart attack, even though they go on diets. So, it doesn't make any difference if you tell someone, if you keep on eating, you're going to die. Too bad. That was my attitude. That was my attitude. My attitude was bad. If you keep on eating, you'll die. It doesn't matter. I can walk across the road, I hit by a truck. What's the difference? A mile to enjoy my food. Bad attitude. So if it's not the medical side of things that will make a decision, or the fact that 3 in 5 Australians are overweight, or the fact that this country last financial year spent $40 billion in the hospitals for obese-related problems. And then we point the finger at the government. That's your fault. The hospitals are overcrowded. We start pointing fingers. Who can we blame? Because I blamed as well, because I didn't take ownership. And that's what it comes down to. We cannot do this. We do have to do this. No more blaming. Look yourself in the mirror and really ask those questions. That's a little bit about where I've come to. It wasn't until I was 2003, Easter, my moment of truth, when my younger brother took some footage. All this food. See, being Italian, I don't know about who's of ethnic background here. Okay, that's all right, even now. I don't know about you, but when it came Christmas or Easter, somehow, somewhere, I developed 3 hands. One hand for the fork, one hand for the knife, and one hand for the bread. It was always there. But it was a way of bringing the family together. It's beautiful. Love it. Do it again. But I watched my portion size this time. We ate, obviously, first, second, third, fourth. It's great. And then from there, we ate so much that we had to sleep. The body couldn't take any more. The body said, okay, I'm going to shut you down while I digest the food. And that's what happens. So we went back. My brother got excited because he brought this new video and let's put it on TV and show us. I said, okay, no problem. He was really busting. Right. Anyhow, so we start watching the movie and I'm looking. And I'm in denial at this stage. Once I saw myself in a three-dimensional way, from the back and from the side, from the neck, that did it. For me, that was my moment of truth. That was my moment of realizing that I needed to do something that I didn't do before. Because all the diets, and we know that diets don't work beforehand, never worked. So this time, it had to work. It had to work this time because it didn't work. Well, the emotion that came out from that was so high, I was just absolutely just repulsive of look at myself. That's what it took me to get me to realize that I had to do something honestly. What happened? So, and that's where my journey started, from that moment onwards. Now, you would have heard from Christian that we've known each other for 10 years and went through what happened from there. So, diets. Diets don't work. And I'll give you all the reasons why diets don't work. Hands up, or someone can tell me in this room, one word, when I hear the word diet, what springs to mind first?
Fad.
Fad.
Restriction.
Restriction.
Can't.
Can't do what?
Can't have what you want.
Can't have your, so you deprive yourself, right? So you can't have that ice cream, that can't care, so you make it forbidden.
Yeah.
Okay, anyone else?
Failure.
Yeah?
Short term.
Short term, exactly, that's what I'm looking for. Short term. Because when we look at that diet, it's short term. We start here and we finish here. We need to shift our minds from diet to lifestyle. Lifestyle starts with L, right? So long term. We need to rearrange the word diet, and from the word diet, we get edit. So we edit our lifestyle and we make changes that are sustainable and real. Not something which is far-fetched and short term. That's another reason why diets don't work. Diets don't work because we expect things to happen overnight. We got this way, I've got that way. It took 20, 30, 25 years to get that way. It wasn't going to happen overnight with a salad and a walk around the block. It was going to take hard work, sweat myself on that bloody cross trainer. So I've given you a story, an idea where I've come. I really understand those where you've been, because I've lived of where those shoes, and where is his shoes tonight? Oh my God. With his shoes on there. Sorry guys, it's a bit cold, but it's okay.
Silvestro, can I just ask, you know when you obviously had your moment of truth, and how long did that last before you waned off it? Like, were there moments where you just were tempted to go back into your normal, day-to-day ritual of eating and not controlling your portion sizes?
Absolutely. We have up days, down days, and I'm no exclusion to anyone else. There's days where you feel that you can't do it, and there's days that you can do it. It depends how much support you have around you, and fortunately for me, I had good support around me with friends, family, my wife at that time, I had good support. But I'm a person that I write things down. I set myself goals. I know it sounds funny, I keep a journal, I have clients, and I get them to keep journals as well. And it's good because it gives you something to aim for. So those down days, I used to always go back. That one question, why? Why do I want to lose weight? Then we go to the how, but why? How would I feel if I don't lose the weight? Why? One of the reasons, it's a good question, is choices. I was limited by choices. I was also limited by the clothes, by hopping onto the bus, by walking to the shop being the last person served because he looks out of ordinary, by all of those means. And I hated that because I wanted to gain my life back again and get choices. So I just always go back to why. I had three reasons why. I believe that some people aren't ready to lose weight because they go into a diet, which we know diets don't work. And as soon as you go into a diet, what happens? You give things up. So, I asked a question earlier, and I had some hands on this side that put their hands up, and they said they're on diets. Okay, so tell me, now that you're on the diet, What have you taken away?
Chocolate.
Okay. So you're not going to have chocolate for the rest of your life. And what? Okay. Anyone else on the diet at the moment that have taken something away? No? Diets are depressing, disappointing, dangerous, disaster. They decrease your energy levels. They're destructive. They're downers. They're depressing. They're frustrating. They deprive. That's what. And expensive, thank you. Anybody else that want to add to my list?
Increased cravings.
Adam and Eve, the forbidden fruit. Was it a green apple or a red apple? Was it a green apple or a red apple? Do we know?
Red.
Forbidden fruit. So, we'll come back to that. The reason why I'll go with you the craving part. When you take something away, being an apple, or being chocolate, or being shoes, or being jewelry, or being your hairdryer, or being your boxing gloves, when you take something away, what happens? You crave for it more. And what happens when you crave for something more? You have more, you think about it. And what happens when you think about it? You binge. And that's why diets don't work, because diets increase your craving. So we know all the reasons why. We've all been there. We've all been on diets. We're on diets. But diets, as I said before, are short term. Great answer. So, if diets don't work, what does? Who can here tell me that, in their point of view, what does work?
Sleeping.
Sleeping?
Well,
okay,
yeah.
So to overcome that, you sleep.
Well, no, I don't eat as much and crave bad foods if I'm sleeping well.
Okay.
I know it's not food related specifically.
But it works?
Yeah.
Okay.
Getting out there and doing exercise.
Exercise? So could you lose weight without exercise?
Yes.
You can, can't you?
Absolutely.
All right. But did you know that 80% of people who continue to exercise after losing the weight, they keep it off? And those who don't, put it back on again? And we all know that 98% of people who lose the weight within the first 2 years will put it back on again. Plus 8 kilos, and they're facts. I've kept mine off for 10 years, 75 kilos. Why? Because I keep on reminding myself. I keep on revisiting my goals. And my solution, why diets don't work, is 3 M's. Mind, mouth, movement. Who here loves to cook? I love cooking. Have you seen my cooking segments on YouTube? Yeah? No, you haven't seen them? Oh, you should go and see them. So who here cooks? Who cooks? Okay, Rhonda. See what happens when you sit right in front and then. How do you make a cake? What ingredients do you need to bake a cake?
Flour, eggs.
Butter? So basically they're all the ingredients. So who's made a cake here? Okay. Who's made a cake here and hath forgotten an ingredient? So what have you forgotten?
I can't remember now, but I remember if I
You forgot. So who here has forgotten an ingredient?
Eggs. In the,
yeah, eggs. Anyone else? I've forgotten flour. Actually, it's but no, there's self-raising and plain flour.
Yeah.
The type of flour, a bit more flour. What happens when you forget or put the wrong ingredient in a cake? So I've put the wrong flour. All right. So, coming back to my solutions, why diets don't work, you need to bake up your recipe properly. And the way you overcome diets and diets don't work is mind, and I'll say it again, mind, mouth, and movement. Without all three ingredients, you won't bake up your success. One or the other will fail.
Did you find that, because this happens a lot, with exercise, that people think that, okay, now that I'm exercising, I can go and eat this Ben & Jerry's tub of ice cream, or you do?
Yeah, I do as well. I'm human as well.
Like, there is a correlation between people that exercise, and then they think, well, because I'm training now, I can eat as much, or I'll go to the gym, then I'll go home and pig out, and I think,
exactly.
Oh, now I'm burning it off. Like,
it gives them the right.
Did that happen with you?
Absolutely. Actually, another reason why diets don't work, and it's a great question, because you sabotage yourself. And you think, well, yes, you go out, you have your ice cream, and then next day, I've got to do 2 hours on spinning. And it's true. It's true. You basically, or you've done your workout, and then as a reward, I've done a workout, I can have my ice cream. So I can have my so basically it's true.
Would you say that that's a form of bulimia?
Absolutely.
Because, you know, people, they'll eat something, then they'll throw up. Or they'll eat and they'll take a drug, they'll eat and they'll go and try and burn it off.
Well, that's where it all comes to a point where they have a bad relationship with food. They give themselves that excuse as well. And there's another form as a food-related disease like anorexia. There's something in that that they must do. But yes, I've experienced that. I've experienced a point where I've done my workout, and that then gives me the right, the excuse, the reason to go out and eat what I want to eat. And knowing that, one way or the other, I'm back to square one, if not worse. That's where it comes down to your lifestyle change. That's where we need to shift from the diet to lifestyle. When you look at a diet and diets don't work, when you look at a diet, look at the outside. Look at a lifestyle, look from the inside. So you need to shift your mindset. Mind, mouth, and movement. We all know about the mouth. We all know what good foods are, bad foods are. It doesn't take a lot to work out that by eating a tub of Jerry's ice cream every day, it's not good for you. We know that the body is made to move. It's non-negotiable. I'm sorry, guys, but the body is designed to move. It's not designed to sit down and not do anything at all. It's designed to move. But the mind controls the mouth and the movement and the want to move from the diet to a lifestyle. So my solution why diets don't work is by using the three M's: mind, mouth, and movement. Like anything in life, if you want something, whatever it must be, you must work towards it and you must really want it. And when you're positive and you're healthy in the mind, then by instilling positive words, you will achieve it. And by doing that, one of the things that I've always done, and I've mentioned this before, I write things down, I write my goals down. I write down realistic goals. Not to a point where I say to myself, I want to lose 10 kilos in 1 week. It's not going to happen. Unrealistic. That's big as loser's garbage. That's the shakes and the bars and everything else as well. They're diets and they don't work because you deprive yourself and put back on again. So the mind. You must really want something to really achieve it. So who here tonight has lost weight by going from a diet to a lifestyle? Anyone? Rhonda, tell us a little bit about what mindset.
I've lost 10 kilos this year.
Right.
And that's why.
What diet did you go on?
I went on a Nightingale.
Oh, see, diets don't work.
Yeah, you go on the diet.
There you go.
It's just by changing what you eat. So I'm just obviously not eating anything that's got sugar in it. I stopped drinking coffee as well. And also, I gave up the alcohol.
Right, so you made some small changes.
I've made some small changes.
Right,
yeah.
Nice one.
I'm still eating carbs, still eating protein, fish.
Exactly. It's a really good point, if I can touch on that, because whenever the body is smart, you can't outsmart the body. It goes into survival mode. Low carbs. I've been there. I've been on a low carb diet. And yes, I've lost 20, 30 kilos within 3 or 4 weeks. But as soon as I introduce carbs back into my body, bang, it went up. It's my body said to me, last time you took last time you took pizza away from me, pasta away from me, bread away from me, I'm going to keep it now. I'm not going to let it go. That's why you put it back on, because the body knows. You cannot trick it. First time, second time, no. And going back to you, you slowly made small changes, realistic, and most of all, sustainable. Some of your challenges as far as why you want to keep, obviously we had times where you were probably craving. Had you overcome craving of going back to your alcohol?
No, I don't crave alcohol at all.
At all?
No, not even sugar.
If you want to go back and have some alcohol, would you have it?
Yeah.
See, diets don't work. In a diet, you take things away in a lifestyle or becomes part of it. Anyone else here has got those? Yes.
I've lost a lot, actually. I used to be about 200 kilos and I've lost 80.
Wow, awesome. Can I go?
But my recipe, my recipe's not right. I'm going to sort a few things out, I guess. So
you lost 80 kilos. Wow, fantastic.
Yes, but I have to just continue on because I feel a bit of a
But that's going to happen. Look, and you know what? The honesty and truth is fantastic because you have ups and downs.
Yeah, but I just
got to
get it. Yeah, I've got it.
I need a kilo as well, done. We basically, she met me when I was at my heaviest, at 130 kilos. And support me throughout that whole time. So, and to be honest with you, she was probably my first girlfriend at 24, 25, who I married. So she was with that throughout the whole time. And we're together for 10 years, always supporting me, and you're right. As you're losing the weight, your mind shift changes as well. Opportunities, not opportunities of other women, but opportunities as far as you have this new lease of life. You have the possibility of running and breathing and as narrow-minded, and you feel like you can do anything in life. And when you've been together with someone for so long, being 10 years, you then tend to be like them and eat like them, and you're comfortable, all comfortable, no problem at all. But after a while, the ships sail in different directions. My way of life was like this, and I found new love in fitness, which gave me great pleasure because I felt good, I looked good. It gave me more confidence, more self-esteem, more options, more choices. Not for other women, but as far as in my life, as far as traveling and work. So I had this new lease of life. Now, my wife saw that as I was getting more confidence and felt that we were drifting apart, which was true. She then joined the gym and lost 10, 15 kilos to be a part of my life. And she understood why I loved this part. And then eventually, the book didn't say it, but at the time I wrote the book in 2007, by the time the book was published, then we were separated. And we left in different parts. But yes, she supported me throughout the whole time. Yes, we went in different directions. It was best that I lead my life, my new life, and that gives her the chance to meet someone else and start a new life. And that's what happened there. So,
did you feel like turning to food, to comfort food during the breakup?
When I went through a breakup, I got over that. Because by that stage, I lost the bulk of my weight within about a year and a half, 2 years. And my body and my mind had time to adjust. Because when you bring changes and when you install new habits, it doesn't happen overnight. You know, if who's Catholic here? Who's Buddha? Okay. So if I tell you right now to change religion, or I use it as one, or you're labeled, you're liberal, and actually change it away, it takes time for you to install new beliefs, new habits. So by losing the weight slowly, it gives you a chance to adjust to new you, to new person, new habits, new smell, new taste, new outlook. But at that time, when I threw my, I went the opposite way. I actually took my frustrations and my and my time at the gym, did my exercise. So that's where, by that time, I was very mentally strong, because exercise does more than just help you lose the weight and shape your body, but also gives you that mental release as well. So that's the benefits of exercise. And I will put that down as one of the most biggest reasons why I've kept the weight off. Because to me, it's just habit. I get lots of emails from people saying, I hate going to the gym. And they say, what should I do? Don't go. It becomes a chore. It's your mindset. Do something different. Go for a walk. Go mountain climbing. Whatever it is. When it comes to changing your lifestyle, do it on your terms. Don't have someone else point the finger, giving you a diet and telling you what to eat, how to eat, when to eat, how much to eat. Do it on your terms. We all know that a salad is healthy. But if you don't like it, why eat it? It's not going to happen. Have something else. Substitute it. Change your lifestyle and change it on your terms. That's what happens. That's one of the biggest reasons why I've kept my weight off. Keeping my weight off is also getting the passion, the enjoyment, because I love the way I feel. I love the way I look. I love the way how I can go and buy clothes, because I love clothes. It doesn't matter what the reason being is. If it's going to help you keep the weight off, if it's going to help you to revisit your goals and move forward, we all have different reasons why we want to lose the weight and keep it off and shift our lifestyle. You hang on to that. Another reason why I've kept my weight off for 75 years is the opportunity to speak to people like yourself, to anyone, to help them to pass on my passion. Because my passion now is to help others. It's a waste if I sat in an office, in a desk. So the more I can be out there and help more people is the other reason why I've kept my weight off. Because I know what I can give to others. So the mind, and we spoke about this, if you have two hangers off, so you need to really revisit, and the mind controls everything. The mouth and the movement will come along. Revisit your goals, write your goals down, and just be truthful and honest with yourself. A lot of people said to me as well, do you do it for yourself, or do you do it for your wife, or do it for your family, do you do it for someone else? And even though sometimes that motivates us to lose weight, to impress someone, or to hang on to someone, it's only a short-term solution. You need to do it for yourself. And that comes with belief. How do I get belief? How do I believe in myself? That comes with support. How do I get support? By talking to people. The support out there now is more than it was 10 years ago. So why diets don't work? Because the short-term. And they're not sustainable. We're all coming here tonight to find out what the solution is. Imagine if you started tomorrow on your lifestyle change. Imagine what will happen in 3 weeks' time. Imagine how you'll feel in 3 months' time. Imagine where you'll be in 6 months' time. Imagine the feeling. Imagine the compliments. Imagine the self-esteem. Imagine the possibilities, the opportunities, the happiness, right? Imagine having those feelings back inside of you. Imagine not having the disappointment and the letdowns and the agony of knowing if we do go on the diet, what's going to happen? It's the same thing that's going to happen if you put your fire over a flame. You know what it's going to do. So why go back onto a diet if we know that you're going to get the same results? And those same results are going to be the results that you've got time after time after time. Disappointment. To avoid your disappointment, and I can't stress this as much, change from your diet to your lifestyle. Change the word diet into edit. Change your lifestyle slowly. It doesn't matter how slow it is. It doesn't matter what you take out or what you adjust. You're moving forward. And I guarantee to you that you will never ever look back and will never go on the diet and you have more control of your life. Imagine where you see yourself in 12 months' time. Imagine fitting into nice clothes. Imagine being able to run with your grandkids, with your children, up the stairs. The opportunities for your career, how happy you'll be, improve your relationship, and more things to go with that. The more energy you'll have. So imagine where you'd be. Roosevelt said one time, some people die at 25, but aren't buried until they're 75. Don't be that person that dies at 25, and for the next 50 years, have a life that with no meaning. So, I've empowered you, hopefully, giving you some of the reasons, I've given you lots of reasons why diets don't work. Solution, mind, mouth, and movement need all three ingredients to move forward. And from that, imagine where you will be. Thank you.
Does anyone have any questions?
During your weight loss journey, did you ever track everything you ate?
Absolutely. So we all heard the question. I always kept a journal, and I do that with the people who the people that I train at the moment. So I keep a journal, and from that journal, I actually wrote my book. So I wrote down basically what I ate, when I ate, and most importantly, at the end, how I felt at the end of the day. So absolutely. By having a journal, I look at it as a journal where I'm the author of my book and I write my chapters.
Hand you over to the king.
Two sales reps were sent to a third world country from a shoe manufacturer, and they were asked to go to this third world country, to a village, to investigate the opportunity to sell shoes to the villagers. So two guys board into a plane, 30, 35 hours, they get to the village. Within 5 minutes of walking into the village, the first sales rep gets on the phone. "Stop, don't send me any shoes. The trouble is here, nobody wears shoes." Okay. "We won't be able to sell them." Within 2 minutes, the second sales rep gets on the phone. "Send me everything you've got, all the shoes. Nobody wears shoes here." Okay. Two sales reps in the same position, the same company. One looks at opportunity, the other looks at misfortune. The other one looks at possibility, the other one gives excuses. So tell me, what's the difference? You can tell me the difference between these two guys, same company. Anyone?
One thinks he can do it, the other one does. One thinks he can do it, one thinks he can't.
That's right. Anyone else? It depends what sort of eyes you look through. It's not all about how big your eye tear is, it's about your eye will. And that's why diets don't work. Diets don't work because we make it too confusing, we put too much information. It's not about that I will, it's I can't. Now, throughout tonight, I'll give you my insight and my struggles so that you can trust me that I'm good enough for you, that you can go home tonight and believe what I have to say might help you in your journey as well. And that's how we come down to this question, why diets don't work. How many here tonight are on a diet? Hands up. Okay? Hands up on those. Diet? Hands up those who have never been on a diet. Wow. Hands up those who are thinking about going on a diet on Monday. Okay. So which Monday? I like that. Who said that? I like that. Which Monday? All right, always Monday. So basically, we're talking about why diets don't work. A lot of people will say calories in, calories out. But it goes beyond that. I'm here tonight to put those wires together. Don't get me wrong, we all have the intention when we do want to go on a diet. The intention is there that you really want to say, this is it. I can do it. I'm going to go on a diet. And I love that. I see the passion in people's eyes when they want to go on a diet. But somewhere in between the intention and the success, the wires are broken. So I'm here to put those wires together, somehow. I'm not an electrician, but I'll try. Okay? I might get electrocuted. There you go. So, some people don't know what they want. The founder of Apple. Who was the founder of Apple computers? Steve Jobs. Said, people don't know what they want until you put it in front of them. Until that happens, we don't know. That's where the diet companies get it right, because they know what to put in front of you. And we're too gullible to take it. And that's why they're still in business, and that's why their pockets are always full. And you aren't full because you're starving yourself, because diets don't work. And that's why, starvation. So we're all here tonight to find out, what does a weight loss king know about why diets don't work? What does he have that he can share? It's all about sharing, that can help anyone here tonight to move forward. And that's what it's all about. Sharing is caring, right? Okay. So diets are short term. There's no quick fix. There's no magic pill, even though there's people out there that would promise you the world and give you broken promises. How often have we been lying in bed watching TV at 3 o'clock in the morning and there's an info commercial? Buy this ab roller, move side to side, get this six pack. My bed was full of them. Under my bed, sorry. They said, you buy this, you can fold as compact underneath. Great, I could put more stuff under my bed. Until Mum said, so I can't vacuum under your bed anymore. So they had it down pat. They knew at 3 a.m. or 2 a.m. in the morning, you are your most vulnerable. You're in bed, you're emotional, you just picked out an ice cream, watched a sad movie. So they know when to strike. They strike it when your emotions are down. And they get you. They give you false hope. I'm not here tonight to give you false hope. I'm here to give you the truth. I'm here to give you what I've done. Not only lost 75 kilos, which is just a number, but I've managed to keep it off. And that's what it comes down to. And I'll give you the solutions tonight of how to keep the weight off. So, I struggled all my life. I'll give you some information about myself. For 25 years I struggled. Being overweight from a young child, 8, 9 years old, Mediterranean background, love my background, love my heritage, and I love my food. That's why diets don't work. Because, let's face it, who doesn't love food? Who doesn't get enjoyment from food? And that's where we need to connect those wires together and fix up that relationship that we have between food. Because diets don't work because what it does, it actually makes us a bad relationship with food. And we cannot do that. Yes, food is energy. That's also pleasure. Back at home, being from a maternal background is also a way of giving, sharing, family together. So it serves more than just energy and pleasure. It's also a way of life and culture as well. Okay, so I was 8 years old when I was starting to get overweight. 25 years until I reached the age of 33. In between that time, it was a pretty sad life, I suppose. Being bullied, being overweight, leaving Sydney, going to the Hunter Valley, being around, at that time back in the 80s, I stood out because I was also ethnic and overweight. I was a target. I was a big target, really big target. That's fine. And that basically lowered my self-esteem, lowered everything about me, but kids are kids and that's how it is. So I've been through the struggles. I've been in the attic, in the dark, dark, dark room, the shades down. Don't want to go anywhere, don't want to do anything, because I was fat and I was ugly. That's reality. Sorry? And I ate some more, because you know why? Why did I eat some more for? Yeah, because food was my friend, exactly. It never answered me back, it was always there, it was warm, it was delicious. It was there, I wasn't rejected. Never had a girlfriend until I was probably 22, 23. That's where I came from. Until I reached 33 years of age, and that's how big I got to. These is my original suit that I had made. Anybody know the Burwood area? There's a guy that makes suits, Mojo. Yeah. Let's see, you open this up, you'll see. Let's have a look. Oh, got the belt on. sorry. But yeah, it's there as well. So a specially made suit. 33 years old, 150 kilos. Now, throughout my whole journey, I tried diets, absolutely. I must have tried 20, 30 diets, from the low protein to the high protein to the low carbs. To the cabbage diet, the detox diet, every single diet. But that always failed.
So, you were married at this time as well. What age did you get married?
I was married at 25.
And what about your wife? Like, was she, did she go on those diets with you, or would she support you or discourage you?
My ex-wife at that time always supported me. The support was, and as we all know, support is important as well. And some of us don't have that support. So we need to find that support. I have a solution for that as well coming up. So she was always supportive, always there. She would see me on the ups and the downs, and the ups and the downs. And we know what they're all about. One of the most famous people in this world, always yo-yo dieting. We know who she is. That's Oprah. Up and down, has everything at her disposal. Trainers, speakers, nutritionists, everything, chefs. So what does this say to you? Diets don't work. Diets don't work. So I really understand the struggles. But in it tonight, we know what's going to happen. What's going to be the take-home message tonight? And what's going to be your question? Exactly, but I will give you the solutions. I'll give you the solutions. So, and that's what it's all about. So throughout my whole life, yes, I attempted every single time. Once again, 2003, Easter. Ooh, something was different. I get to see this when I talk about this. My moment of truth. We'll come back to that. Now, it takes something to really happen to move you. Now, 3 in 5 Australians, 12 million Australians, right now are overweight. 75% of heart victims who have a heart attack will go in the second time they have a heart attack, even though they go on diets. So it doesn't make any difference if you tell someone, if you keep on eating, you're going to die. Too bad. That was my attitude. That was my attitude. My attitude was bad. If you keep on eating, you'll die. It doesn't matter. I can walk across the road, I hit by a truck. What's the difference? I might as well enjoy my food. Bad attitude. So if it's not the medical side of things that will make a decision, or the fact that 3 in 5 Australians are overweight, or the fact that this country last financial year spent $40 billion in the hospitals for obese-related problems. And then we point the finger at the government. That's your fault. The hospitals are overcrowded. We start pointing fingers. Who can we blame? Because I blamed as well, because I didn't take ownership. And that's what it comes down to. We cannot do this. We have to do this. No more blaming. Look yourself in the mirror and really ask those questions. That's a little bit about where I've come to. It wasn't until I was 2003, Easter, my moment of truth, when my younger brother took some footage. All this food. See, being Italian, I don't know about who's of ethnic background here. Okay, that's all right, even now. I don't know about you, but when it came Christmas or Easter, somehow, somewhere, I developed 3 hands. One hand for the fork, one hand for the knife, and one hand for the bread. It was always there. But it was a way of bringing the family together. It's beautiful. Love it. I'll do it again. But I watched my portion size this time. We ate, obviously, first, second, third, fourth. It's great. And then from there, we ate so much that we had to sleep. The body couldn't take any more. The body said, okay, I'm going to shut you down while I digest the food. And that's what happens. So we went back. My brother got excited because he brought this new video and let's put it on TV and show us. I said, okay, no problem. He was really busting. Right. Anyhow, so we start watching the movie and I'm looking. And I'm in denial at this stage. Once I saw myself in a three-dimensional way, from the back and from the side, from the neck, that did it. For me, that was my moment of truth. That was my moment of realizing that I needed to do something that I didn't do before. Because all the diets, and we know that diets don't work beforehand, never worked. So this time, it had to work. It had to work this time, because it didn't work. Well, the emotion that came out from that was so high, I was just absolutely just repulsive of look at myself. That's what it took me to get me to realize that I had to do something honestly. That's what happened. So, and that's where my journey started from that moment onwards. Now, you would have heard from Christian that we've known each other for 10 years and went through what happened from there. So, diets don't work. And I'll give you all the reasons why diets don't work. Hands up, or someone can tell me in this room, one word, when I hear the word diet, what springs to mind first?
Fad.
Restriction.
Restriction.
Can't.
Can't do what?
Can't have what you want.
Can't have what, so you deprive yourself, right? So you can't have that ice cream, that can't care, so you make it forbidden.
Yeah.
Okay, anyone else?
Failure?
Yeah?
Short term.
Exactly, that's what I'm looking for. Short term. Because when we look at that diet, it's short term. We start here and we finish here. We need to shift our minds from diet to lifestyle. Lifestyle starts with L, right? So long term. We need to rearrange the word diet, and from the word diet, we get edit. So we edit our lifestyle and we make changes that are sustainable and real. Not something which is far-fetched and short-term. That's another reason why diets don't work. Diets don't work because we expect things to happen overnight. We got this way, I've got that way. It took 20, 30, 25 years to get that way. It wasn't going to happen overnight with a salad and a walk around the block. It was going to take hard work, sweat myself on that bloody cross trainer. So I've given you a story, an idea where I've come. I really understand those where you've been, because I've lived of where those shoes, and where is his shoes tonight? Oh my God. With his shoes on there. Sorry guys, it's a bit cold, but it's okay.
So, can I just ask, you know, when you obviously had your moment of truth, and how long did that last before you waned off it? Like, were there moments where you just were tempted to go back into your normal, day-to-day ritual of eating and not controlling your portion sizes?
Absolutely. We have up days, down days, and I'm no exclusion to anyone else. There's days where you feel that you can't do it, and there's days that you can do it. It depends how much support you have around you, and fortunately for me, I had good support around me with friends, family, my wife at that time, I had good support. But I'm a person that I write things down. I set myself goals. I know it sounds funny, I keep a journal, I have clients, and I get them to keep journals as well. And it's good because it gives you something to aim for. So those down days, I used to always go back to one question, why? Why do I want to lose weight? Then we go to the how, but why? How would I feel if I don't lose the weight? Why? One of the reasons, it's a good question, is choices. I was limited by choices. I was also limited by the clothes, by hopping onto the bus, by walking to the shop being the last person served because he looks out of ordinary, by all of those means. And I hated that because I wanted to gain my life back again and get choices. So I just always go back to why. I had three reasons why. I believe that some people aren't ready to lose weight because they go into a diet, which we know diets don't work. And as soon as you go into a diet, what happens? You give things up. So I asked a question earlier, and I had some hands on this side that put their hands up, and they said they're on diets. Okay, so tell me, now that you're on the diet, what have you taken away?
Chocolate.
Okay. So you're not going to have chocolate for the rest of your life. And what? Okay. Anyone else on the diet at the moment that have taken something away? No? Diets are depressing, disappointing, dangerous, disaster, they decrease your energy levels, they're destructive, they're downers, they're depressing, they're frustrating, they deprive. That's what. And expensive, thank you. Anybody else that want to add to my list?
Increased cravings.
Adam and Eve, the forbidden fruit. Was it green apple or red apple? Was it a green apple or a red apple? Do we know?
Red.
Forbidden fruit. So, we'll come back to that. The reason why I'll go with you the craving part. When you take something away, being an apple, or being chocolate, or being shoes, or being jewelry, or being your hairdryer, or being your boxing clothes, when you take something away, what happens? You crave for it more. And what happens when you crave for something more? You have more, you think about it. And what happens when you think about it? You binge. And that's why diets don't work, because diets increase your craving. So we know all the reasons why. We've all been there. We've all been on diets. We're on diets. But diets, as I said before, are short term. Great answer. So, if diets don't work, what does? Who can here tell me that, in their point of view, what does work?
Sleeping.
Sleeping?
Well,
okay,
yeah.
So to overcome that, you sleep.
Well, no, I find I don't eat as much and crave bad foods if I'm sleeping well.
Okay.
I know it's not food related specifically.
But it works.
Yeah.
Okay.
Getting out there and doing exercise.
Exercise? So could you lose weight without exercise?
Yes.
You can, can't you?
Absolutely.
All right. But did you know that 80% of people who continue to exercise after losing the weight, keep it off? And those who don't, put it back on again? And we all know that 98% of people who lose the weight within the first 2 years will put it back on again, plus 8 kilos, and they're facts. I've kept mine off. for 10 years, 75 kilos. Why? Because I keep on reminding myself. I keep on revisiting my goals. And my solution, why diets don't work, is 3 M's. Mind, mouth, movement. Who here loves to cook? I love cooking. Have you seen my cooking segments on YouTube? Yeah? No, you haven't seen them? Oh, you should go and see them. So who here cooks? Who cooks? Okay, Rhonda. See what happens when you sit right in front and then. How do you make a cake? What ingredients do you need to bake a cake?
Flour, eggs.
Butter. So basically they're all the ingredients. So who's made a cake here? Okay. Who's made a cake here and hath forgotten an ingredient? So what have you forgotten?
I can't remember now, but I remember if I...
You forgot. So who here has forgotten an ingredient?
Eggs. In the,
eggs.
Yeah.
Anyone else? I've forgotten flour. Actually, that's... but no, there's self-raising and plain flour.
Yeah.
The type of flour. I put on flour. What happens when you forget or put the wrong ingredient in a cake? So I've put the wrong flour. All right. So coming back to my solutions, why diets don't work, you need to bake up your recipe properly. And the way you overcome diets and diets don't work is mind, and I'll say it again, mind, mouth, and movement. Without all three ingredients, you won't bake up your success. One or the other will fail.
Did you find that, because this happens a lot, with exercise, that people think that, okay, now that I'm exercising, I can go and eat this Ben and Jerry's tub of ice cream, like, you do it?
Yeah, I do as well. I'm human as well.
Like, there is a correlation between people that exercise, and then they think, well, because I'm training now, I can eat as much, if I'll go to the gym, then I'll go home and pig out, and I think,
exactly.
Oh, I'm burning it off. Like,
it gives them the right.
Did that happen with you?
Absolutely. Actually, another reason why diets don't work, and it's a great question, because you sabotage yourself. And you think, well, yes, you go out, you have your ice cream, and then next day, I've got to do 2 hours on spinning. And it's true. It's true. You basically, or you've done your workout, and then as a reward, I've done a workout, I can have my ice cream. So I can have my so basically it's true.
Would you say that that's a form of bulimia?
Absolutely.
Because, you know people, they'll eat something, then they'll throw up. Or they'll eat and they'll take a drug, they'll eat and they'll go and try and burn it off.
Well, that's where it all comes to a point where they have a bad relationship with food. They give themselves that excuse as well. And there's another form as a food-related disease like anorexia. There's something in that that they must do. But yes, I've experienced that. I've experienced a point where I've done my workout, and that then gives me the right, the excuse, the reason to go out and eat what I want to eat. And knowing that, one way or the other, I'm back to square one, if not worse. That's where it comes down to your lifestyle change. That's where we need to shift from the diet to lifestyle. When you look at a diet and diets don't work, when you look at a diet, look at the outside. Look at a lifestyle, look from the inside. So you need to shift your mindset. Mind, mouth, and movement. We all know about the mouth. We all know what good foods are, bad foods are. It doesn't take a lot to work out that by eating a tub of Jerry's ice cream every day, it's not good for you. We know that the body is made to move. It's non-negotiable. I'm sorry, guys, but the body is designed to move. It's not designed to sit down and not do anything at all. It's designed to move. But the mind controls the mouth and the movement and the want to move from the diet to a lifestyle. So my solution why diets don't work is by using the three M's: mind, mouth, and movement. Like anything in life, if you want something, whatever it must be, you must work towards it and you must really want it. And when you're positive and you're healthy in the mind, then by instilling positive words, you will achieve it. And by doing that, one of the things that I've always done, and I've mentioned this before, I write things down, I write my goals down. I write down realistic goals. Not to a point where I say to myself, I want to lose 10 kilos in 1 week. It's not going to happen. Unrealistic. That's big as loser's garbage. That's the shakes and the bars and everything else as well. They're diets and they don't work because you deprive yourself and put back on again. So the mind. You must really want something to really achieve it. So who here tonight has lost weight by going from a diet to a lifestyle? Anyone? Rhonda, tell us a little bit about what mindset.
I've lost 10 kilos this year.
Right.
And that's why.
What diet did you go on?
No, I didn't go on
diets.
Oh,
see, diets don't
work. Yeah,
you go
on the diet.
There you go.
It's just by changing what you eat. So I'm just obviously not eating anything that's got sugar in it. I stopped drinking coffee as well. And also, I gave up the alcohol.
Right, so you made some small changes.
Right,
yeah. Nice one.
I'm still eating carbs, still eating protein, fish.
Exactly, it's a really good point if I can touch on that, because whenever you go on a diet, it always takes something away from you. It takes one of the five major food groups, being carbs, being protein, being sugars, being fats, being fruit and vegetables. It takes something. The body is smart. You can't outsmart the body. It goes into survival mode. Low carbs. I've been there. I've been on a low carb diet, and yes, I've lost 20, 30 kilos within 3 or 4 weeks. But as soon as I introduced carbs back into my body, bang, it went up. My body said to me, last time you took carbohydrates, last time you took pizza away from me, pasta away from me, bread away from me, I'm gonna keep it now. I'm not gonna let it go. That's why you put it back on, because the body knows. You cannot trick it. First time, second time, no. And going back to you, you slowly made small changes, realistic, and most of all, sustainable. Some of your challenges as far as why you want to keep, obviously we had times where you were probably craving. Had you overcome craving of going back to your alcohol?
No, I don't crave alcohol at all.
At all?
No, not even sugar.
If you want to go back and have some alcohol, would you have it?
Yeah.
See, diets don't work. In a diet, you take things away in a lifestyle, or becomes part of it. Anyone else here has got, yes?
I've lost a lot, actually. I used to be about 200 kilos, and I've lost 80.
Wow! Awesome! What's
your name, John? My recipe's not right. I'm going to sort a few things out, I guess. But
you lost 80 kilos. Wow, fantastic.
But I have to just continue on, because I feel a bit of a beef.
But that's going to happen. Look, and you know what? The honesty and truth is fantastic, because you have the ups and downs.
Yeah. But
I'm
just going to get it.
One here. 80 kilos, well done.
I think I really need to share with everyone, I already seen your book, because you hit some bumps in the road, and when you lost the bulk of your weight, you know, you spoke about support, your wife was always there to support you to lose the weight, but then when you lost the bulk of your weight, you no longer had her support. In actual fact, she was trying to, well, this is what I read in the book, was trying to sabotage you to go the other way. Something
had
changed within you.
Yeah, it's true actually. It's I suppose we first met when we But basically, she met me when I was at my heaviest, at 130 kilos. And support me throughout that whole time. So, and we'll to be honest with you, she was probably my first girlfriend at 24, 25, who I married. So she was with that throughout the whole time. And we're together for 10 years, always supporting me, and you're right. As you're losing the weight, your mind shift changes as well. Opportunities, not opportunities of other women, but opportunities as far as you have this new lease of life. You have the possibility of running and breathing, and you're as narrow-minded, and you feel like you can do anything in life. And when you've been together with someone for so long, be it 10 years, you then tend to be like them and eat like them, and you're comfortable, all comfortable, no problem at all. But after a while, the ships sail in different directions. My way of life was like this, and I found new love in fitness, which gave me great pleasure because I felt good, I looked good. It gave me more confidence, more self-esteem, more options, more choices. Not for other women, but as far as in my life, as far as traveling and work. So I had this new lease of life. Now, my wife saw that as I was getting more confidence and felt that we were drifting apart, which was true. She then joined the gym and lost 10, 15 kilos to be a part of my life. And she understood why I loved this part. And then eventually, the book didn't say it, but at the time I wrote the book in 2007, by the time the book was published, then we're separated. And we left in different parts. But yes, he supported me throughout the whole time. Yes, we went in different directions. It was best that I leave my life, my new life, and that gives her the chance to meet someone else and start a new life. And that's what happened there. So,
did you feel like turning to food, to comfort food during the breakup?
No, actually, when I went through a breakup, I got over that. Because by that stage, I lost the bulk of my weight within about a year and a half, 2 years. And my body and my mind had time to adjust. Because when you bring changes and when you install new habits, it doesn't happen overnight. You know, if who's Catholic here? Who's Buddha? Okay. So if I tell you right now to change religion, or I'll use it as one, or you're labeled or you're liberal and actually change straight away, it takes time for you to install new beliefs, new habits. So by losing the weight slowly, it gives you a chance to adjust to new you, to new person, new habits, new smell, new taste, new outlook. But at that time, when I went the opposite way. I actually took my frustrations and my time at the gym, did my exercise. So that's where, by that time, I was very mentally strong, because exercise does more than just help you lose the weight and shape your body, but also gives you that mental release as well. So that's the benefits of exercise. And I will put that down as one of the most biggest reasons why I've kept the weight off. Because to me, it's just habit. I get lots of emails from people saying, I hate going to the gym. And they say, what should I do? Don't go. It becomes a chore. It's your mindset. Do something different. Go for a walk. Go mountain climbing. Whatever it is. When it comes to changing your lifestyle, do it on your terms. Don't have someone else point the finger, giving you a diet and telling you what to eat, how to eat, when to eat, how much to eat. Do it on your terms. We all know that a salad is healthy, but if you don't like it, why eat it? It's not going to happen. Have something else. Substitute it. Change your lifestyle and change it on your terms. That's what happens. That's one of the biggest reasons why I've kept my weight off. Keeping my weight off is also getting the passion, the enjoyment, because I love the way I feel. I love the way I look. I love the way how I can go and buy clothes because I love clothes. It doesn't matter what the reason being is. If it's going to help you keep the weight off, if it's going to help you to revisit your goals and move forward, we all have different reasons why we want to lose the weight and keep it off and shift our lifestyle. You hang on to that. Another reason why I've kept my weight off for 75 years is the opportunity to speak to people like yourself, to anyone, to help them to pass on my passion. Because my passion now is to help others. It's a waste if I sat in an office, in a desk. So the more I can be out there and help more people is the other reason why I've kept my weight off. Because I know what I can give to others. So the mind, and we spoke about this, if we have two hanging those off, so you need to really revisit, and the mind controls everything. The mouth and a movement will come along. Revisit your goals, write your goals down, and just be truthful and honest with yourself. A lot of people said to me as well, do you do it for yourself, or do you do it for your wife, or do it for your family, do you do it for someone else? And even though sometimes that motivates us to lose weight, to impress someone, or to hang on to someone, it's only a short-term solution. You need to do it for yourself. And that comes with belief. How do I get belief? How do I believe in myself? That comes with support. How do I get support? By talking to people. The support out there now is more than it was 10 years ago. So why diets don't work? Because the short-term, and they're not sustainable. And we'll all come here tonight to find out what the solution is. Imagine if you started tomorrow on your lifestyle change. Imagine what will happen in 3 weeks' time. Imagine how you'll feel in 3 months' time. Imagine where you'll be in 6 months' time. Imagine the feeling. Imagine the compliments. Imagine the self-esteem. Imagine the possibilities, the opportunities, the happiness, right? Imagine having those feelings back inside of you. Imagine not having the disappointment and the letdowns. And the agony of knowing if we do go on the diet, what's going to happen? It's the same thing that's going to happen if you put your fire over a flame. You know what it's going to do. So why go back onto a diet if we know that you're going to get the same results? And those same results are going to be the results that you got time after time after time. Disappointment. To avoid your disappointment, and I can't stress this as much, change from your diet to your lifestyle. Change the word diet into edit. Change your lifestyle slowly. It doesn't matter how slow it is. It doesn't matter what you take out or what you adjust. You're moving forward. And I guarantee to you that you will never ever look back and will never go on the diet and you'll have more control over your life. Imagine where you see yourself in 12 months' time. Imagine fitting into nice clothes. Imagine being able to run with your grandkids, with your children, up the stairs. The opportunities for your career, how happy you'll be, improving your relationship, and more things to go with that. The more energy you'll have. So imagine where you'd be. Roosevelt said one time, some people die at 25 but aren't buried until they're 75. Don't be that person that dies at 25 and for the next 50 years have a life that with no meaning. So, I've empowered you, hopefully, giving you some of the reasons, I've given you lots of reasons why diets don't work. Solution, mind, mouth, and movement need all three ingredients to move forward. And from that, imagine where you will be. Thank you. Questions?
Does anyone have any questions?
During your weight loss journey, do you ever track everything you ate?
Absolutely. So we all heard the question. I always kept a journal, and I do that with the people who the people that I train at the moment. So I keep a journal, and from that journal, I actually wrote my book. So I wrote down basically what I ate, when I ate, and most importantly, at the end, how I felt at the end of the day. So absolutely. By having a journal, because I look at it as a journal where I'm the author of my book and I write my chapters,
over to the king.
Two sales reps were sent to a third world country from a shoe manufacturer, and they were asked to go to this third world country, to a village, to investigate the opportunity to sell shoes to the villagers. So two guys board into a plane, 30, 35 hours, they get to the village. Within 5 minutes of walking into the village, the first sales rep gets on the phone. Stop, don't send me any shoes. Trouble is here, nobody wears shoes. Okay. We won't be able to sell them. Within 2 minutes, the second sales rep gets on the phone. Send me everything you've got. All the shoes. Nobody wears shoes here. Okay. Two sales reps in the same position, the same company. One looks at opportunity. The other looks at misfortune. The other one looks at possibility. The other one gives excuses. So tell me, what's the difference? You can tell me the difference between these two guys, same company. Anyone?
One thinks he can do it, the other one thinks he can do it, one thinks he can't.
That's right. Anyone else? It depends what sort of eyes you look through. It's not all about how big your eye tear is, it's about your eye will. And that's why diets don't work. Diets don't work because we make it too confusing, we put too much information. It's not about that I will, it's I can't. Now, throughout tonight, I'll give you my insight and my struggles so that you can trust me that I'm good enough for you, that you can go home tonight and believe what I have to say might help you in your journey as well. And that's where we come down to this question, why diets don't work. How many here tonight are on a diet? Hands up. Okay? No, hands up on those. Diet? Hands up those who have never been on a diet. Wow. Hands up those who are thinking about going on a diet on Monday. Okay. So which Monday? I like that. Who said that? I like that. Which Monday? All right, always Monday. So basically, we're talking about why diets don't work. A lot of people will say calories in, calories out. But it goes beyond that. I'm here tonight to put those wires together. Don't get me wrong. We all have the intention when we do want to go on the diet. The intention is there that you really want to say, this is it. I can do it. I'm going to go on the diet. And I love that. I see the passion in people's eyes when they want to go on the diet. But somewhere in between the intention and the success, the wires are broken. So I'm here to put those wires together somehow. I'm not an electrician, but I'll try. Okay? I might get electrocuted. There you go. So some people don't know what they want. The founder of Apple. Who was the founder of Apple computers? Steve Jobs. Said, people don't know what they want until you put it in front of them. Until that happens, we don't know. That's where the diet companies get it right, because they know what to put in front of you. And we're too gullible to take it. And that's why they're still in business, and that's why their pockets are always full. And you aren't full because you're starving yourself, because diets don't work. And that's why, starvation. So we're all here tonight to find out, what does a weight loss king know about why diets don't work? What does he have that he can share? It's all about sharing. They can help anyone here tonight to move forward. And that's what it's all about. Sharing is caring, right? Okay. So diets are short term. There's no quick fix. There's no magic pill, even though there's people out there that would promise you the world and give you broken promises. How often have we been lying in bed watching TV at 3 o'clock in the morning and there's an info commercial? Buy this ab roller, move side to side, get this six pack. My bed was full of them. Under my bed, sorry. They said, you buy this, you can fold as compact underneath. Great, I could put more stuff under my bed. Until Mum said, I can't vacuum under your bed anymore. So they had it down pat. They knew at 3 a.m. or 2 a.m. in the morning, you are at your most vulnerable. You're in bed, you're emotional, you just picked out an ice cream, watched a sad movie. So they know when to strike. They strike it when your emotions are down. And they get you. They give you false hope. I'm not here tonight to give you false hope. I'm here to give you the truth. I'm here to give you what I've done. Not only lost 75 kilos, which is just a number, but I've managed to keep it off. And that's what it comes down to. And I'll give you the solutions tonight of how to keep the weight off. So, I struggled all my life. I'll give you some information about myself. For 25 years I struggled. Being overweight from a young child, 8, 9 years old, Mediterranean background, love my background, love my heritage, and I love my food. That's why diets don't work. Because, let's face it, who doesn't love food? Who doesn't get enjoyment from food? And that's where we need to connect those wires together and fix up that relationship that we have between food, because diets don't work, because what it does, it actually makes us a bad relationship with food. And we cannot do that. Yes, food is energy. That's also a pleasure. Back at home, being from a maternity background is also a way of giving, sharing, family together. So it serves more than just energy and pleasure. It's also a way of life and culture as well. Okay, so I was 8 years old when I was starting to get overweight. 25 years until I reached the age of 33. In between that time, it was a pretty sad life, I suppose. Being bullied, being overweight, living in Sydney, going to the Hunter Valley, being around, at that time back in the 80s, I stood out because I was also ethnic and overweight. I was a target. I was a big target. Really big target. That's fine. And that basically lowered my self-esteem, lowered everything about me. But kids are kids, and that's how it is. So I've been through the struggles. I've been in the attic, in a dark, dark, dark room, the shades down. Don't want to go anywhere, don't want to do anything, because I was fat and I was ugly. That's reality. Sorry? And I ate some more, because you know why? Why did I eat some more for? Yeah, because food was my friend, exactly. It never answered me back, it was always there, it was warm, it was delicious. It was there, I wasn't rejected. Never had a girlfriend until I was probably 22, 23. That's where I came from. Until I reached 33 years of age. And that's how big I got to. These is my original suit that I had made. Anybody know the Burwood area? There's a guy that makes suits, Mojo. Yeah, let's see, you open this up, you'll see. Let's have a look. Oh, got the belt on, sorry. But yeah, it's there as well. So a specially made suit. 33 years old, 150 kilos. Now throughout my whole journey, I tried diets, absolutely. I must have tried 20, 30 diets, from the low protein to the high protein to the low carbs. to the cabbage diet, the detox diet, every single diet. But that always failed.
So you were married this time as well. What age did you get married?
I was married at 25.
And what about your wife? Like, did she go on those diets with you, or did she support you?
My ex-wife at that time always supported me. The support with them. And as we all know, support is important as well. And some of us don't have that support. So we need to find that support. I have a solution for that as well coming up. So she was always supportive, always there. She would see me on the ups and the downs, and the ups and the downs. And we know what that's all about. One of the most famous people in this world, always yo-yo dieting. We know who she is. That's Oprah. Up and down, has everything at her disposal. Trainers, speakers, nutritionists, everything. Chefs. So what does this say to you? Diets don't work. Diets don't work. So I really understand the struggles. But in it tonight, we know what's going to happen. What's going to be the take-home message tonight? And what's going to be your question?
What do we do?
Exactly, but I will give you the solutions. So, and that's what it's all about. So throughout my whole life, yes, I attempted every single time. Once again, 2003, Easter. Ooh, something was different. I get shivers when I talk about this. My moment of truth. We'll come back to that. Now, it takes something to really happen to move you. Now, 3 in 5 Australians, 12 million Australians, right now are overweight. 75% of heart victims who have a heart attack will go in the second time and have a heart attack, even though they go on diets. So it doesn't make any difference if you tell someone, if you keep on eating, you're going to die. Too bad. That was my attitude. That was my attitude. My attitude was bad. If you keep on eating, you'll die. It doesn't matter. I can walk across the road, I hit by a truck. What's the difference? I might as well enjoy my food. Bad attitude. So if it's not the medical side of things that will make a decision, or the fact that 3 in 5 Australians are overweight, or the fact that this country last financial year spent $40 billion in the hospitals for obese-related problems. And then we point the finger at the government. That's your fault. The hospitals are overcrowded. We start pointing fingers. Who can we blame? Because I blamed as well, because I didn't take ownership. And that's what it comes down to. We cannot do this. We do have to do this. No more blaming. Look yourself in the mirror and really ask those questions. That's a little bit about where I've come to. It wasn't until I was 2003, Easter, my moment of truth, when my younger brother took some footage. All this food. See, being Italian, I don't know about who's of ethnic background here. Okay, that's all right. Even now. I don't know about you, but when it came Christmas or Easter, somehow, somewhere, I developed 3 hands. One hand for the fork, one hand for the knife, and one hand for the bread. It was always there. But it was a way of bringing the family together. It's beautiful. Love it. I'll do it again. But I watched my portion size this time. We ate, obviously, first, second, third, fourth. It's great. And then from there, we ate so much that we had to sleep. The body couldn't take any more. The body said, okay, I'm going to shut you down while I digest the food. And that's what happens. So we went back. My brother got excited because he brought this new video and let's put it on TV and show us. I said, okay, no problem. He was really busting. Right. Anyhow, so we start watching the movie and I'm looking. And I'm in denial at this stage. Once I saw myself in a three-dimensional way, from the back and from the side, from the neck, that did it. For me, that was my moment of truth. That was my moment of realizing that I needed to do something that I didn't do before. Because all the diets, and we know that diets don't work beforehand, never worked. So this time, it had to work. It had to work this time, because it didn't work. Well, the emotion that came out from that was so high, I was just absolutely just repulsive of look at myself. That's what it took me to get me to realize that I had to do something honestly. That's what happened. So, and that's where my journey started, from that moment onwards. Now, you would have heard from Christian that we've known each other for 10 years and went through what happened from there. So, Diets don't work, and I'll give you all the reasons why diets don't work. Hands up, or someone can tell me in this room, one word, when I hear the word diet, what springs to mind first?
Fad.
Restriction.
Restriction.
Can't.
Can't do what?
Can't have what you want.
Can't have, so you deprive yourself, right? So you can't have that ice cream, that can't care, so you make it forbidden.
Yeah.
Okay, anyone else?
Failure?
Yeah?
Short term.
Exactly, that's what I'm looking for. Short term. Because when we look at that diet, it's short term. We start here and we finish here. We need to shift our minds from diet to lifestyle. Lifestyle starts with L, right? So long term. We need to rearrange the word diet, and from the word diet, we get edit. So we edit our lifestyle and we make changes that are sustainable and real. Not something which is far-fetched and short-term. That's another reason why diets don't work. Diets don't work because we expect things to happen overnight. We got this way, I got that way. It took 20, 30, 25 years to get that way. It wasn't going to happen overnight with a salad and a walk around the block. It was going to take hard work, sweat myself on that bloody cross trainer. So I've given you a story, an idea where I've come. I really understand those where you've been, because I've lived of where those shoes, and where is his shoes tonight? Oh my God. Put his shoes on there. Sorry guys, it's a bit cold, but it's okay.
Silvestro, can I just ask, you know when you obviously had your moment of truth, and how long did that last before you waned off it? Like, were there moments where you just were tempted to go back into your normal, day-to-day ritual of eating and not controlling your portion sizes?
Absolutely. We have up days, down days, and I'm no exclusion to anyone else. There's days where you feel that you can't do it. And there's days that you can do it. It depends how much support you have around you. And fortunately for me, I had good support around me with friends, family, my wife at that time, I had good support. But I'm a person that I write things down. I set myself goals. I know it sounds funny. I keep a journal. I have clients and I get them to keep journals as well. And it's good because it gives you something to aim for. So those down days, I used to always go back to that one question, why? Why do I want to lose weight? Then we go to the how, but why? How would I feel if I don't lose the weight? Why? One of the reasons, it's a good question, is choices. I was limited by choices. I was also limited by the clothes, by hopping onto the bus, by walking to a shop being the last person served because he looks out of the ordinary, by all of those means. And I hated that because I wanted to gain my life back again and get choices. I just always go back to why. I had three reasons why. I believe that some people aren't ready to lose weight because they go into a diet, which we know diets don't work. And as soon as you go into a diet, what happens? You give things up. So I asked a question earlier, and I had some hands on this side that put their hands up, and they said they're on diets. Okay, so tell me, now that you're on the diet, what have you taken away?
Chocolate.
Okay. So you're not going to have chocolate for the rest of your life. Am I? Okay. Anyone else on the diet at the moment that have taken something away? No? Diets are depressing. disappointing, dangerous, disaster, they decrease your energy levels, they're destructive, they're downers, they're depressing, they're frustrating, they deprive. That's what. And expensive, thank you. Anybody else that want to add to my list?
Increased cravings.
Adam and Eve, the forbidden fruit. Was it green apple or red apple? Was it a green apple or a red apple? Do we know?
Red.
Forbidden fruit. So, we'll come back to that. The reason why I'll go with you the craving part. When you take something away, being an apple, or being chocolate, or being shoes, or being jewelry, or being your hairdryer, or being your boxing gloves, when you take something away, what happens? You crave for it more. And what happens when you crave for something more? You have more, you think about it. And what happens when you think about it? You binge. And that's why diets don't work, because diets increase your craving. So we know all the reasons why. We've all been there. We've all been on diets. We're on diets, diets, diets. But diets, as I said before, are short term. Great answer. So, if diets don't work, what does? Who can here tell me that, in their point of view, what does work?
Sleeping.
Sleeping?
Sleep well.
Okay, so to overcome that, you sleep.
Well, no, I find I don't eat as much and crave bad foods if I'm sleeping well.
Okay.
I know it's not food related specifically.
But it works?
Yeah.
Okay.
Getting out there and doing exercise.
Exercise? So could you lose weight without exercise?
Yes.
Yes.
You can, can't you? All right. But did you know that 80% of people who continue to exercise after losing the weight, keep it off? And those who don't, put it back on again? And we all know that 98% of people who lose the weight within the first 2 years will put it back on again, plus 8 kilos. And they're facts. I've kept mine off for 10 years, 75 kilos. Why? Because I keep on reminding myself. I keep on revisiting my goals. And my solution why diets don't work is 3 M's. Mind, mouth, movement. Who here loves to cook? I like cooking. Have you seen my cooking segments on YouTube? Yeah? No, you haven't seen them? Oh, you should go and see them. So who here cooks? Who cooks? Okay, Rhonda. See what happens when you sit right in front and then. How do you make a cake? What ingredients do you need to bake a cake?
Flour, eggs.
Butter. So basically they're all the ingredients. So who's made a cake here? Okay. Who's made a cake here and hath forgotten an ingredient? So what have you forgotten?
I can't remember now, but I remember if I...
You forgot. So who here has forgotten an ingredient?
Eggs.
Eggs.
Yeah.
Anyone else? I've forgotten flour. Actually, but no, there's self-raising and plain flour.
Yeah.
The type of flour. I put normal flour. What happens when you forget or put the wrong ingredient in a cake? So I've put the wrong flour. All right. So coming back to my solutions, why diets don't work, you need to bake up your recipe properly. And the way you overcome diets and diets don't work is mind, and I'll say it again, mind, mouth, and movement. Without all three ingredients, you won't bake up your success. One or the other will fail.
Did you find that, because this happens a lot, with exercise, that people think that, okay, now that I'm exercising, I can go and eat this Ben and Jerry's tub of ice cream, like, I do. You do?
Yeah, I do as well. I'm human as well.
There is a correlation between people that exercise, and then they think, well, because I'm training now, I can eat as much, or I'll go to the gym, then I'll go home and pig out, and I think,
exactly.
Oh, now I'm burning it off. Like,
it gives them the right.
Did that happen with you?
Absolutely. Actually, another reason why diets don't work, and it's a great question, because you sabotage yourself. And you think, well, yes, you go out, you have your ice cream, and then next day, I've got to do 2 hours on spinning. And it's true. It's true. You basically, or you've done your workout, and then as a reward, I've done a workout, I can have my ice cream. I can have my so basically it's true.
Would you say that that's a form of bulimia?
Absolutely.
Because, you know, people, they'll eat something, then they'll throw up, or they'll eat and they'll take a drug, they'll eat and they'll go and try and burn it off.
Well, that's where it all comes to a point where they have a bad relationship with food. They give themselves that excuse as well. And there's another form as a food related disease like anorexia. There's something in that they must do. But yes, I've experienced that. I've experienced a point where I've done my workout and that then given me the right, the excuse, the reason to go out and eat what I want to eat. And knowing that, one minute the other, I'm back to square one, if not worse. That's where it comes down to your lifestyle change. That's where we need to shift from the diet to lifestyle. When you look at a diet and diets don't work, when you look at a diet, look at the outside. Look at a lifestyle, look from the inside. So you need to shift your mindset. Mind, mouth, and movement. We all know about the mouth. We all know what good foods are, bad foods are. It doesn't take a lot to work out that by eating a tub of Jerry's ice cream every day, it's not good for you. We know that the body is made to move. It's non-negotiable. I'm sorry, guys, but the body is designed to move. It's not designed to sit down and not do anything at all. It's designed to move. But the mind controls the mouth and the movement and the want to move from the diet to a lifestyle. So my solution why diets don't work is by using the three M's: mind, mouth, and movement. Like anything in life, if you want something, whatever it must be, you must work towards it and you must really want it. And when you're positive and you're healthy in the mind, then by instilling positive words, you will achieve it. And by doing that, one of the things that I've always done, and I've mentioned this before, I write things down, I write my goals down. I write down realistic goals. Not to a point where I say to myself, I want to lose 10 kilos in 1 week. It's not going to happen. It's unrealistic. That's big as loser's garbage. That's the shakes and the bars and everything else as well. They're diets and they don't work because you deprive yourself and put back on again. So the mind. You must really want something to really achieve it. So who here tonight has lost weight by going from a diet to a lifestyle? Anyone? Rhonda, tell us a little bit about what mindset.
I've lost 10 kilos this year.
Right.
And that's why.
What diet did you go on?
No, I didn't go on the diet.
Oh, see, diets don't work.
Yeah, you go on the diet.
There you go.
It's just by changing what you eat. So I'm just obviously not eating anything that's got sugar in it. I stopped drinking coffee as well. And also, I gave up the alcohol.
Right, so you made some small changes.
I made some small changes.
Right,
yeah.
Nice one.
I'm still eating carbs, still eating protein, fish,
Exactly. It's a really good point, if I can touch on that, because whenever you go on a diet, it always takes something away from you. It takes one of the five major food groups, being carbs, being protein, being sugars, being fats, being fruit and vegetables. It takes something. The body is smart. You can't outsmart the body. It goes into survival mode. Low carbs. I've been there. I've been on a low carb diet. And yes, I've lost 20, 30 kilos within 3 or 4 weeks. But as soon as I introduce carbs back into my body, bang, it went up. It's my body said to me, last time you took carbohydrates, sorry, last time you took pizza away from me, pasta away from me, bread away from me, I'm going to keep it now. I'm not going to let it go. That's why you put it back on, because your body knows. You cannot trick it. First time, second time, no. And going back to you, you slowly made small changes, realistic, and most of all, sustainable. Some of your challenges as far as why you want to keep, obviously we had times where you were probably craving. Had you overcome craving of going back to your alcohol?
No, I don't crave alcohol at all.
At all?
No, not even sugar.
If you want to go back and have some alcohol, would you have it?
Yeah.
See, diets don't work. In a diet, you take things away in a lifestyle, all becomes part of it. Anyone else here has got those? Yes.
I've lost a lot, actually. I used to be back 200 kilos and I've lost 80.
Wow. Awesome. Can I go?
But my recipe, my recipe's not right. I'm going to sort a few things out, I guess.
But you lost 80 kilos. Wow, fantastic.
But I have to just continue on because I feel a bit of a beef fat one.
But that's going to happen. Look, and you know what? The honesty and truth is fantastic because you have the ups and downs.
Yeah. But I just
got to
get it. Yeah, I'm going to. That's why I'm here.
80 kilos. Well done.
I think I need to share with everyone. I already seen your book. Because you hit some bumps in the road. And when you lost the bulk of your weight, you know, you spoke about support. Your wife was always there to support you to lose the weight. But then when you lost the bulk of your weight, you no longer had her support. In actual fact, she was trying to, well, this is what I read in the book, was trying to sabotage you to go the other way, because something had changed within you.
Yeah, it's true, actually. It's I suppose we first met when we basically, she met me when I was at my heaviest, at 130 kilos, and supported me throughout that whole time. So. And to be honest with you, she was probably my first girlfriend at 24, 25, who I married. So she was with that throughout the whole time. And we were together for 10 years, always supporting me, you're right. As you're losing the weight, your mind shift changes as well. Opportunities, not opportunities of other women, but opportunities as far as you have this new lease of life. You have the possibility of running and breathing and you're as narrow-minded, and you feel like you can do anything in life. And when you've been together with someone for so long, be it 10 years, you then tend to be like them and eat like them, and you're comfortable, all comfortable, no problem at all. But after a while, the ships sail in different directions. My way of life was like this, and I found new love in fitness, which gave me great pleasure because I felt good, I looked good. It gave me more confidence, more self-esteem, more options, more choices. Not for other women, but as far as in my life, as far as traveling and work. So I had this new lease of life. Now, my wife saw that as I was getting more confidence and felt that we were drifting apart. This was true. She then joined the gym and lost 10, 15 kilos to be a part of my life. And she understood why I love this part. And then eventually, the book didn't say it, but at the time I wrote the book in 2007, by the time the book was published, then we're separated. And we left in different parts. But yes, he supported me throughout the whole time. Yes, we went in different directions. It was best that I leave my life, my new life, and that gives her the chance to meet someone else and start a new life. And that's what happened there.
Yeah,
So
did you feel like turning to food, to comfort food during the breakup?
No, actually when I went through a breakup, I got over that. Because by that stage, I lost the bulk of my weight within about a year and a half, 2 years. And my body and my mind had time to adjust. Because when you bring changes and when you install new habits, it doesn't happen overnight. You know, if who's Catholic here? Who's Buddha? Okay. So if I tell you right now to change religion, or I'll use it as one, or you're labeled or you're liberal and actually change straight away, it takes time for you to install new beliefs, new habits. So by losing the weight slowly, it gives you a chance to adjust to new you, to new person, new habits, new smell, new taste, new outlook. But at that time, when I threw my, I went the opposite way. I actually took my frustrations and my time at the gym, do my exercise. So that's where, by that time, I was very mentally strong, because exercise does more than just help you lose the weight and shape your body, but also gives you that mental release as well. So that's the benefits of exercise. And I will put that down as one of the most biggest reasons why I've kept the weight off. Because to me, it's just habit. I get lots of emails from people saying, I hate going to the gym. And they say, what should I do? Don't go. It becomes a chore. It's your mindset. Do something different. Go for a walk, go mountain climbing, whatever it is. When it comes to changing your lifestyle, do it on your terms. Don't have someone else point the finger, giving you a diet and telling you what to eat, how to eat, when to eat, how much to eat. Do it on your terms. We all know that a salad is healthy, but if you don't like it, why eat it? It's not going to happen. Have something else. Substitute it. Change your lifestyle and change it on your terms. That's what happens. That's one of the biggest reasons why I've kept my weight off. Keeping my weight off is also getting the passion, the enjoyment, because I love the way I feel. I love the way I look. I love the way how I can go and buy clothes, because I love clothes. It doesn't matter what the reason being is. If it's going to help you keep the weight off, if it's going to help you to revisit your goals and move forward, we all have different reasons why we want to lose the weight and keep it off and shift our lifestyle. You hang on to that. Another reason why I've kept my weight off for 75 years is the opportunity to speak to people like yourself, to anyone, to help them, to pass on my passion. Because my passion now is to help others. It's a waste if I sat in an office, in a desk. So the more I can be out there and help more people is the other reason why I've kept my weight off. Because I know what I can give to others. So the mind, and we spoke about this, if you have two hangers off, so you need to really revisit, and the mind controls everything. The mouth and a movement will come along. Revisit your goals, write your goals down, and just be truthful and honest with yourself. Other people said to me as well, do you do it for yourself, or do you do it for your wife, or do it for your family, do you do it for someone else? And even though sometimes that motivates us to lose weight, to impress someone, or to hang on to someone, it's only a short-term solution. You need to do it for yourself. And that comes with belief. How do I get belief? How do I believe in myself? That comes with support. How do I get support? By talking to people. The support out there now is more than it was 10 years ago. So why diets don't work? Because the short-term, and they're not sustainable. And we'll all come here tonight to find out what the solution is. Imagine Imagine if you started tomorrow on your lifestyle change. Imagine what will happen in 3 weeks' time. Imagine how you'll feel in 3 months' time. Imagine where you'll be in 6 months' time. Imagine the feeling. Imagine the compliments. Imagine the self-esteem. Imagine the possibilities, the opportunities, the happiness, right? Imagine having those feelings back inside of you. Imagine not having the disappointment and the letdowns and the agony of knowing if we do go on the diet, what's going to happen? It's the same thing that's going to happen if you put your fire over a flame. You know what it's going to do. So why go back onto a diet if we know that you're going to get the same results? And those same results are going to be the results that you've got time after time after time. Disappointment. To avoid your disappointment, and I can't stress this as much, change from your diet to your lifestyle. Change the word diet into edit. Change your lifestyle slowly. It doesn't matter how slow it is. It doesn't matter what you take out or what you adjust. You're moving forward. And I guarantee to you that you will never ever look back and will never go on the diet and you'll have more control over your life. Imagine where you see yourself in 12 months' time. Imagine fitting into nice clothes. Imagine being able to run with your grandkids, with your children, up the stairs. The opportunities for your career, how happy you'll be, improve your relationship, and more things to go with that, the more energy you'll have. So imagine where you'd be. Roosevelt said one time, some people die at 25, but aren't buried until they're 75. Don't be that person that dies at 25, and for the next 50 years, have a life that with no meaning. So, I've empowered you, hopefully, give you some of the reasons, I've given you lots of reasons why diets don't work. Solution, mind, mouth, and movement. Need all three ingredients to move forward. So from that, imagine where you will be. Thank you.